asthma drug could block coronavirus protein, study finds. Numerous vaccines and a couple of pills are now available to effectively combat COVID-19. But that isn't stopping other research groups from doing more. Recently, a drug used for asthma has been found with anti-COVID activity. Although further research is required, the team figured out how it works against the coronavirus. Asthma and COVID-19 are two different conditions, despite the lungs as the primary site of the issue. There are many types of anti-asthma out there, and one of them has been around for over 20 years. Montelukast is an oral medication used to treat asthma in hives. According to the Mayo Clinic, montelukast may prevent the number of asthma attacks and reduce asthma symptoms. However, it shouldn't be taken during an asthma attack. Doctors may also prescribe the drug for hay fever and seasonal allergic rhinitis. At the Indian Institute of Science, researchers brought a surprise about this asthma drug. Published in the journal eLife, the team presented the drug's ability to bind to and block a key protein of the COVID-19 virus. Bound and blocked, the diminished levels of this protein would reduce the viral replication of SARS-CoV-2 inside human immune cells. Their investigation was centered on the SARS-CoV-2 protein called NSP1, one of the first released inside human cells. It could bind to ribosomes and immune cells and shut down the synthesis of critical proteins. This would cripple the immune system, so disrupting NSP1 should damage the coronavirus. To find possible disruptors, the team used a computational model to screen more than 1,600 FDA-approved drugs. The shortlist of drugs that could bind very well to NSP1 included both montelukast and the anti-HIV drug saquinavir. Next, they cultured cells that would produce NSP. These were treated with both montelukast and saquinavir, but only the former could save the cells from the tyranny of NSP1. When they analyzed how it worked, they determined that montelukast strongly binds to the C-terminal of the viral protein. This weakened the hold of the protein on the ribosomes, freeing affected cells from viral slavery. Meanwhile, saquinavir could also do it but lacks the needed stability in leashing the viral protein. What about mutation? Study senior author Tanweer Hussain said, "The mutation rate in this protein, especially the C-terminal region, is very low compared to the rest of the viral proteins." This isn't the first time montelukast was linked to COVID-19. Another study published in the Journal of Asthma revealed that hospitalized COVID-19 patients treated with montelukast had fever events of clinical deterioration. Researchers suggested that it might feature clinical activity against the virus, but they couldn't confirm it in that study. Montelukast is not yet approved or authorized medication for COVID-19. What do you think of the study findings? Should the health agencies look into it as well? Share your thoughts in the comment section. Till our next video, thanks for watching.